Greetings, everyone, and welcome back for the Windows Server Summit. We're going to talk about what's ahead for Windows Server, and I'm joined by the General Manager for Windows Server, Hari Pulapaka.
Thank you, Jeff.
Hey, it's really awesome that you're here.
It's awesome to be here. I love talking to you, connecting with our customers. This is going to be awesome.
One of the things, obviously, as we look at Windows Server 2025, it's a huge product, and it's really chock full of innovation.
Yeah.
And I look across the entire product, and I'm excited by lots of different aspects. But I'm just kind of wondering, if you had to point to like two or three specific aspects for Windows Server 2025, what are some of the things that you wanna highlight?
So, you know, when we started planning Windows Server 25, we wanted to pick a few themes that would resonate with our customer, that are important to our customer, that are valuable to our customer to make their lives better. So the big themes that we sort of landed on are quality. We want to make sure Windows Server 25 is the highest quality, most reliable, the best performance, the most secure Windows Server 2025 yet. We focused on hybrid. We want to make sure, like a lot of our customers, you know, they have machines on-prem, they have servers on-prem, but they also use the cloud. They use multi-cloud. And so we expect this kind of hybrid environment to sort of be the durable state. Nobody is like, hey, I'm only going to use a disconnected world. They will all be in some sort of a hybrid state. And so we focused on hybrid, and we wanted to bring real value in hybrid to our customers. And then security, you know, we look at the world today, It has a lot of threats. And so we wanted to make sure Windows Server 25 focuses on giving you the right protection, the right advances that you need to keep your infrastructure, keep your mission critical software safe and secure. For example, you know, with Intel, we built HLAC that gives you protection for your hypervisor and your VMs.
Okay.
We built something called CET that allows you to make sure that, you know, kernel CET that allows you to make sure that your software doesn't do stack bypasses. So a little bit,
yeah. But this is good hardcore innovation that we've delivered in 2025 to help protect our customers' apps and workloads.
Exactly, and these are all things that just make it so much more harder for the attackers to go after your infrastructure.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So hybrid, quality, security, agree with you. Let's talk about security for a second.
Yeah.
I know when I talk with customers, a lot of times security is something that's very top of mind.
Correct.
How do you see the security landscape that has kind of shifted for customers?
You know, the security landscape is constantly evolving. You guys all know this. I don't need to explain this to you. Hackers are getting increasingly sophisticated.
Yeah.
Nation state attacks are going after your infrastructure because, you know, that's how they get high value information. And so we at Microsoft understand all of this, right? We have thousands of cybersecurity professionals daily looking after our cloud and using the same technology to make sure our on-prem software that we build is guarded against, right? So for example, the way we build Windows Server, we run actual pen test, we run actual fuzzing. And these are the same protection that everybody, like all of us use in our cloud infrastructure as well. And so, you know, as you think about the security landscape, we have decided to make Windows Server one of the most secure pieces of software that we can build, at least one of the best Windows Server till date. And so whether it's your mission critical workload like file server, AD, or your Exchange, or your SQL, you know, Windows Server 2025 gives you a lot of features. You know about VBS, virtualization-based security.
Yes.
That's sort of been our cornerstone of security, right? We built something called HVCI. It's basically code integrity that's protected by your hypervisor. So that way, if you have kernel malware, if you have admin malware, they can't attack your code integrity. They can't attack your code integrity features. We've done a bunch of crypto optimization improvements. We've deprecated older protocols, like, you know, SMB 1.0 is no longer enabled. We've added TLS 1.3, which is the latest TLS standard. And so we updated Active Directory to support new Kerberos features.
Mm-hmm.
And so overall, you know, I think security is an area we take very seriously. We want all our customers to use the latest so that they are safe. They keep their infrastructure safe, right?
And those security changes, really, as a good description, it's really across the board. It's not just one technology.
Correct.
Yes, we've done a bunch of things on the hypervisor.
Correct.
Yes, we've gotten rid of old protocols.
Yes.
We've also hardened the firewall. We're getting rid of NTLM.
Correct.
Something that's been around since the 90s, my friend.
Yeah.
It's really incredible what's going on. And so the security work is happening across hypervisor protocols, storage, networking, so much more.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I think in general, you know, we care deeply about our customers' quality, reliability, security, performance. So, you know, Windows Server 25 is sort of a culmination of all of these efforts.
But if you look at it immediately, you're going to notice, wait a minute, this doesn't look like the older versions of Windows Server. This has things that are more in common with Windows 11. It's got the experience as well as some features like Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Mm-hmm. So tell us how you think about modernizing the Windows Server experience.
You know, Jeff, we talk to our customers. This sounds like obviously you talk to our customers, but no, we talk to our customers. And what we hear from customers is that they actually use the desktop. On Windows Server, Windows Server is not just sitting under the, you know, in the back of the thing connected to the Ethernet. They actually use the desktop. They log into your Windows Server, and then they use the desktop to set up their firewall. They use the desktop to set up their rules. They use the desktop to install roles and definitions and all of those things. And our customers are comfortable using the desktop. You know, they use Windows PCs as their primary device. And so they're used to using all of this. And so as we look at this data, it becomes apparent to us that, you know, if people want choice, and the choice is they want to use desktop, we want to make sure they get the best experience they can with the desktop. It is, we don't want to force them into a, hey, Windows Server should be headless, and so there's never going to be a desktop on it. That's not, we want to give customers the choice, and if they want to use desktop, more power to you, we want to give. And so as we went down Windows Server 25, what we did is we wanted to make sure it gets all of the same user interface. Same modernized user interface that Windows 11 has. And so when you start using Windows Server 25, you will see that it has the same taskbar. Mm-hmm. It has the same task manager. It has the same settings app. You know, these are the things that you're used to using on your PCs. You know, you could use something like Wingate now. It was never possible before. You can use Wingate to install apps from your command line, install WSL using Wingate, mm-hmm. right?
Sysinternals.
You mentioned
Visual Studio Code, SQL Server.
Like, these are all advances that only happen because we are listening to our customers and giving them what they want. Like, hey, if you want to use Server Core, that is completely supported. Don't get me wrong. If you want to use a headless version, Server Core is still there. We still love Server Core. If you want to use Windows Server Desktop, we are modernizing it to make it more in line with Windows 11. And so, you know, for historically, we never had Wi-Fi. We didn't have Bluetooth.
Yeah.
So especially for people who are using Windows Server as a workstation, imagine not having Wi-Fi. So you have to run your wires everywhere. Now with Wi-Fi, you get it by default.
Cool.
You get Bluetooth enabled by default. You can use Bluetooth keyboards. It's like, you know, just overall, it just feels like a much more customer-friendly product with Windows Server 25.
And the other nice thing about Wi-Fi in particular is for those people that want to deploy more servers at the edge,
right,
where they may not have a hardwire available, but Wi-Fi is everywhere, guess what? Now it's right there.
Exactly. Absolutely.
So one thing I want to point out is, you know, when as we get ready for 2025 shipping later this year,
yeah,
one of the questions that I always get asked, I'm going to put on the businessman's hat for just a second. Someone's going to go, okay, so, you know, I want my organization to upgrade to 2025, but I want to minimize risk as much as possible. That's always the big question I get asked is, well, I'm worried that it's going to break an app or that it's going to be hard or that process is really, really difficult. Yep. Unlike on Windows like client, where we upgrade you from 8 to 10 to 11 and it's all just, you know, very easy and you know, it's a simple process.
Yeah.
What would you tell someone about the upgrade process in Windows Server 2025 and the work we've done there?
Hey, we talked about this one core and this thing, and I feel like I'm going to sound like broken record.
No.
But here's another reason why that's super useful.
Mm-hmm.
With Windows Server 25, what you can do now is you can open settings, go to your update. Oh, sorry, Windows Server 2022. You can go to your update. You click update, and you will get Windows Server 25 right there within the update settings.
Wait a minute. Let me say this one more time. You're telling me with Windows Server 2022,
correct,
which has been shipping now for a couple of years,
correct,
I'll be able to go to Windows Update, and there'll be an option to go right to 2025.
Absolutely. You do not need a media anymore. It's not like the old school world. Windows Server is now more and more like with the advances that you have with client. We have actual in-band update. So you can be on 2022 and you can hit update and you can go to Windows Server 25, just like you can do with your client.
All right, well listen, any last comments you want to leave us with?
I want to thank our customers for using Windows Server. You know, whether you are a disconnected Windows Server user, whether you're a Windows Server user in the cloud, any cloud, whether you're a hybrid user who works on-prem or in the cloud, you know, thank you. We want to meet you where you are, and so we want to make you successful with using Windows Server. So thank you for using it.